Bibles to Psalms 92. Psalms 92. Just want to look at the Word of God for a few moments tonight. And then I want to get us around the altar to take the Word of God and season it with prayer. Praise the Lord. Probably one of my favorite verses is in the book of Galatians. Paul writes to that church in Galatia. And he says, "Let us not be weary in well-doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not." We know that the principles of sowing is what we're going to reap. We know that this walk with God, things aren't accomplished overnight. Did you ever notice that? Things in the walk with God are not accomplished overnight. And along the road, you'll see a lot of landmarks, and you'll see a lot of wrecks. Sometimes it just takes time and dreams and visions and desires to see the fulfillment of what God has for us. And we look at those who work hard. You know, it's nail after nail that the carpenter sees the finished product. It's block after block the mason sees his product. It's word after word that is written that the author sees his final work. And it's crop after crop the farmer sees that he has done what he's been called to do. And really for the traveler, it's mile after mile and step after step until he makes progress. And so this thing that we're in this relationship with God, certainly is a progressive work, isn't it? And what He gives us a vision for, maybe early even in our life, sometimes it's some time before it's done. Amen. Others may stop along the way, and others may get sidetracked along the way, but God has called us to be faithful unto the end, because He will be faithful to the end. Praise God. And so I'd like to look here in Psalms 92, verse number 12 and 13. The Bible says, "The righteous shall flourish like the palm tree. He shall grow like a cedar in Lebanon. Those who be planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of our God." Now, I know this is preaching to the choir because you're here on Sunday night. But let me just say, there's a reason why we're in church. Why we like to be here when the doors are open, because the Word of God says that that one who is planted in the house of God, he's going to flourish in the courts of our God. Amen. I want to flourish in the things of God. I have some other goals I want to accomplish in life, but the greatest goal should be that we flourish in the things of God. Amen. David said the righteous would be like a palm tree. He shall grow like the cedar in Lebanon. Now, I hope I'm not getting ahead of myself by saying this, because I initially was going to say this in my closing. But whether it's down here, Brother David, where we're getting things, amen, from God, or whether it's up here where God is providing, God provides. Down below and up above. Amen. God knows exactly where we are, Sister Rachel, and God provides for us. Amen. God, He has many pictures in the Word of God that we can grow by. But He's given us, in the book of Psalms, He's given us the palm tree and He's given us the cedar. Let's look at the palm tree first thing. The palm tree, you know, if you know anything about trees, some trees can be grafted into other trees. Some trees, a cutting can be cut. You might notice this tree out here that's growing up in the wires that are running up the road. Well, Brother Kern Fiddler, that came from his place. And all it was you go a certain time of year when the trees are budding for these trees, and you cut them at where they're connected together, and all you got to do is stick them down the ground. And Sister Jenny, they take off and grow on their own. I know that because I did that. But the palm tree, Sister Rachel, can't be like that. It can't be grafted. It can't be cut off. It has to come from a seed. And that seed, it grows by seed alone. The only way that we will ever, as believers, do anything from the kingdom of God, I can't be grafted into you and you can't be grafted into me, although we're one body. But Brother David, the seed of God's word has to find a place in the very fertile soil of our heart. And Sister Sandy, then it has to take off and then it will grow. Amen. So David said that the righteous shall flourish like a palm tree. Amen. There's some things about the palm tree that I want us to think about this evening. I'm talking about God wants to plant us and grow us, Sister Barbara, into something great. Amen. So Brother George, this palm tree, amen, two things about Brother Irvin, it's this. It's always green and it's always bearing fruit. Amen. God doesn't allow us to have a season where we dry up and we become dormant. Amen. God always keeps us in a position where we are green and we're bearing sweet fruit. Amen. And the interesting thing about the palm tree, and we love that. We go to the ocean and we look at the palm trees. One of the most splendid sights when you go to the shore. But one thing about that palm tree, Brother Eli, there's some crazy winds and storms that come off the ocean, Brother Josh. And so that palm tree, it must be willing to bend in the middle of the storm. And though it bends, after the storm is gone, amen, it will find itself erected, amen, it's endured the blast of the hurricane, but it is not defeated. Hallelujah. God said that's what He's going to do for us. Amen. Those who are righteous, we will endure the blast of the storms. Amen. The storms come and the storms go. Amen. But it will never defeat the child of God. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. If the tree is damaged, the top will begin to grow straight. Amen. 50 to 100 feet. Amen. It takes 30 years to mature, but that palm tree, it said that its roots go down over 100 feet and it thrives in adversity. It produces little where there is little rain. Think about that, Brother David. You look at that palm tree and we don't think much about it, but 100 feet since we're tipping into the ground is that palm tree's roots. It takes 30 years to mature, but its roots are deep. It may take us as believers. It takes us time to mature. But all through the storms of adversity, may it be known that we will not be defeated because our roots are deep in Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Brother George, that's why you smile. Amen. That's why you walk in victory, because your roots are deep. Amen. The adversity of life. Amen. So what do we do when things are dry? And where do you go when the heavens are shut up? And when it seems like you're the only one walking in righteousness? I'll tell you what we do. We share the gospel anyway. We believe anyway. We pray anyway. That's what we do. There will be dry seasons, oh palm tree. But God is able to keep you green, and God is able to keep you producing fruit. Amen. You see, when Hezekiah was sick, what did he do? He prayed that God would lengthen him. Amen. When David, he found himself running. Amen. He found faith in God. Blind Bartimaeus, what did he do? He cried out for God. God, give me light to my eyes. Amen. Elijah, he prayed for rain. Amen. What we have need of, amen, we've got to ask God for. Hannah said, oh, God, give me a son. God gave her son. Paul prayed, amen, God, remove this. But Sister Jenny, God said, my grace is sufficient. God gave him grace. Amen. I want you to know that prayer is not limited to a geography. Amen. You can pray anywhere you want. Jonah, Brother David, he prayed in the middle of the ocean, down in the deep. Amen. He was crying out on God. Peter prayed on that housetop. Hezekiah prayed in his bed. Jesus prayed in the mountain. Amen. Jairus prayed in the street. David prayed in a cave. Amen. When it gets dry, what are we going to do? We're going to trust God. We're going to ask Him for what we need. We're going to pray. No matter where we are. The Word of God says that the righteous shall flourish like the palm tree. Let me talk about prayer for a moment. Prayer happens in many kinds of ways. Peter prayed on troubled sea. The publican, he prayed short. Moses at the tabernacle, he prayed long. Solomon, he prayed long at the dedication of the temple. Hannah, she prayed in silence. It was aloud like the Syrophoenician woman, "Oh, have mercy, my God, here she cries from the temple." It was tears like Mary Magdalene cried as Jesus was there by Josh. That's how she prayed. In groans like David, we can pray any time of day, morning or noon, or night. Amen. But we know that Daniel prayed three times a day. Amen. We know that at noon, Paul and Silas were at midnight. Samuel prayed. Timothy in his youth prayed. The centurion as adult would pray. In his aged years, Simeon prayed. In sickness, Job prayed. In death, Jacob prayed. Amen. I need to tell you that every prayer that's prayed, no matter where you geographically are, the hearer of prayers always hears. That's why we can flourish like the palm tree. Hallelujah. That's why we can flourish like the palm tree. You may say, "Well, it's just not right in my life, Brother Seville. Things haven't gone the way that I want. I'm not even really where I thought I would be spiritually in my walk. I'm not where I am financially or physically." Amen. And those aren't the goals that we're looking at. Amen. We're looking at the goals of living righteous before God. And God says, if you will live righteous, you will flourish like the palm tree. Amen. I need to tell you that righteousness in God's eyes, it flourishes. The cedar. Let's look at that tonight. The cedar, it's in a place that's a lot different than the palm tree. The cedar in particular, in Lebanon here, where the Bible mentions, there are some good things about that. If you read Sister Tina, you'll read that the king of Tyre actually took the cedars of Lebanon and he cut them. And Sister Jenny, that was what was used to make the framework and the rafters of the temple. And so, though that structure was very strong, it really endured. Think about how the structures of this building, your home, other buildings, you may not see them, but you want to have good structure. You want to make sure you have good quality lumber. So here it is. Amen. God said that He will make us like the cedars of Lebanon. Hey, listen, don't underestimate a child of God. Don't underestimate that one that's living righteous before God. Brother Dennis, we may not see everything, but there's some strong foundations. Amen. There's some strong framework. Amen. That is holding up the men and women of God because God has built them. Amen. They're like the cedars of Lebanon. Amen. So here it is, the underpinning, the framing, the rafter work. Amen. Huge. Amen. Though it was not seen. Amen. It still is the inward bracing. Amen. That takes the outward pressure. No matter what happens, Brother David, in life, for the child of God, the inward bracing. Amen. It's the security of the cedars of Lebanon. Amen. God has made us strong like them. Something strong enough on the inside that bears everything on the outside. You ever look at someone serve God for something and you say, "Man, they're strong." But Irvin, they're strong. You know why they're strong? It's because the structure on the inside. God has built them to endure whatever happens on the outside. Child of God, you can make it. Amen. What supports you and embraces you and gives you strength to stand will endure any outward pressure. These grow in unlikely conditions, really extreme weather condition. Tyre is a coastal city that was on the Mediterranean Sea. And so think about that. There were very humid type temperatures that would happen in what we would know as the summer months. Humidity also brings with it thunderstorms and storms. And so the cedars, Brother Craig, they endure all those storms. Hurricanes, they have a tendency to spin off and be destructive on the Mediterranean Sea. But Brother Doug, those cedars endured that. And so because of its elevation, over 600,000 feet above sea level, there's not much vegetation that's being found in those mountains of Lebanon. And so all that's really there is cedar. And what does that mean to us? That means that it's not really a good place to grow. Everybody, I talk to folks and they say, wow, if I was born in a different generation, or if I was born in a different city, or if I was born in a different family, you know what I want to say to them in a very polite way? Hogwash. God knows what you need. And whatever the situation, God has planted you to survive. Amen. Here it is, the height of these cedars, the commitment of their abilities. Amen. Here it is, no matter what happened, they're enduring. It reminds me of a man way back in the book of Genesis. Amen. We know that his brothers betrayed him. They told all types of stories about him. Here he is cast into prison. He comes out of prison. He's been betrayed by Potiphar's wife. It just has not been the road that you wanted to go, Sister Jenny. But oh, Joseph, God says you're like a cedar, Joseph. Amen. In the unlikely of circumstances, you're thriving and you're growing. Brother and sister, no matter what circumstances we have, God has designed us to be like a palm tree. God has designed us to be like the cedar. Strong, hallelujah, victorious. We're going to make it. The Word of God says, trust in the Lord with all our heart. Lean not into our own understanding. In all our ways acknowledge Him, and He shall direct our path. Amen. The path of the cedar. Amen. It's going around the rock and down deep. Amen. Because it will thrive in unlikely conditions. My friend, saint of God, that's what God has created you to do.
It has deep roots. It rises to 60, 80 feet tall, but the roots probe down into the earth. It stretches around rocks. It stretches down into caverns where there's water because it needs to survive. Some scientists, and I'm talking from a biblical perspective, have estimated that some of these cedars are over 3,000 years old. Can you imagine, Brother David? You know why, Brother Eli? Because God has designed them to thrive in situations that are not always optimal. God creates the child of God to survive and to thrive as we go deep searching for the water. There is a river that flows from deep within. There is a fountain that frees the soul from sin. Amen. There's a river tonight. Let your roots go around the rock. Let it go sinking deep that you may find the river of God and that you may flourish. See, it's amazing that these trees have stood. Nothing can demoralize or demolish the child of God. They will stand in His righteousness. Amen. They will stand. Let me just share something in the next closing moments. The church is full of too many willow trees, easily bent this way or that. They're full of too many aspens that they tremble and break underneath the storm. Full of too much bramble that they poke and prod everything that's around them. And God says the design for the child of God is to flourish like a palm tree and to grow like the cedars of Lebanon. Into every life some rain will fall. The Bible says it's going to rain on the just and the unjust. What's the difference between the just and the unjust? Because Brother David, the just flourishes. Because God allows them to put roots down deep in Him. And He provides water, Sister Jim. The just
is like the palm tree. There are not seasons of looking good and producing, but Brother Dennis, it is how the life of the child of God is. I read some things about the palm tree on the internet. When you look at those particular palm trees, everything about the fruit is edible. Everything about it. Palm tree provides acacia berries, and I say acacia berries. They provide coconut, they provide some type of fig, dates. Things that are very healthy. Things that are good. In fact, some people call it heavenly fruit because it's so. Tonight I want you to know that God wants to do something in your life. He wants to produce heavenly fruit.
Hallelujah.
Brother George, there's a lot of people out there that want to share gossip and lies and rumors and get folks worked up and attack characters of folks and just constantly unhappy. That's not the child of God, you know. The child of God is producing fruit that folks can partake of, and it's healthy. Why can we have hope where things look bleak? Because our hope is in Jesus. Why can we have joy when things would rob other people of joy? Because the visitation of God's presence in His fullness is, in His presence is fullness of joy. Because God wants us to grow and flourish. Sister Beth will come to the piano tonight. It's been a very busy weekend, hasn't it? At least, you know, with a lot going on in our church. I really pray, ask God, God, what is the world for today? Do I preach on faith? Do I preach on hope? Do I preach on healing? And I find God drawing me here. It's about flourishing. It's about growing. Brother George, I know you're taking treatment, but God wants you to grow and flourish during this time. You are, and you're going to continue to. I want to see God. I love what God did this morning and bringing our church together. That was powerful, wasn't it? It was a beautiful service. You know what God was saying? He was saying you're flourishing. The presence of God, the Spirit of God. And folks say, I may bend in storm, but my roots are deep in Christ, wrapping around the rock of ages. What are the things in your life tonight? Amen. I want you to know that God desires for you in unlikely conditions to thrive and to be strong. And in the storm, He wants you to be green and produce. Storms aren't always humid condition, rainy conditions. They're not always. There's a lot of really good moments. I like those times where the sun is shining and spring and summer. We enjoy those, don't we? So if that's the season you're in, remember, let those roots go down deep. But if you're in a first season, know this, that your roots are deep. And God is going to allow you to flourish in His courts. That's what He promises. This evening, the altars are open. We'll be gathering in. Can we embrace God and pray and say, God, here I am geographically. I'm praying for my situation, whether it's short, whether it's long, whether it's loud, whether it's quiet. Amen. Pray and ask God, God, I want to flourish in this situation. Would you gather in tonight?